Hoot boy, a lot of things happen in this one. I can shorten it down, I think, though. The Invisible Man starts walking down the street, realizing there's no way he can actually do pretty much anything. If he eats, he becomes visible again because there's food inside of his body. Same thing if he drinks anything. So he's gotta find clothes. He starts walking down an area and he thinks, well, there's people who make costumes for theaters in this sort of district over this way. So he goes over there, finds a shop that actually has costumes, and then he ends up in this really weird, like, stealth game with the guy who runs the place. He opens the door to go inside, he waits a little bit, and the guy comes out. But when he does, this guy's got, like, really good hearing, so every single time the Invisible Man moves, this guy turns and looks exactly where he was. He starts looking throughout his whole shop and being kind of paranoid. It's not really paranoid if somebody's actually there, though. So he tries to find a way to get all the things that he needs, but every time he does, this guy hears him, and he starts, like, going around his house and locking all the doors in the place. He seems to have some idea of what's causing all these weird noises and shit to happen around him, but he doesn't pinpoint what it is exactly. Then he bumps into the Invisible Man. The Invisible Man decides this guy is definitely here alone, so I don't have to worry about anything, and he just knocks him down the stairs. He hits him in the head really hard, and then he ties him up in a sheet like a bag. Then he goes, gets all the things that he needs to, clothes-wise, and he gets a mask and a bunch of that stuff. And he looks grotesque, as he puts it, but not so grotesque that he couldn't possibly be a human being. Like, he looks fucked up, but not so fucked up that he's obviously a person wearing a mask. He then goes to get food, and then he starts to eat, and that's his part of the story. Then Kemp starts asking him questions like, is this when you went to Iping? And he's like, yeah, and I'll tell you why I went to Iping. He's like, what about all that other stuff, like with the constable and everything? The guy's like, man, they were pissing me off. Did I happen to kill anybody? No, you didn't kill anybody. I'm not sure where they're going with this. The idea of trying to make it so, like, he didn't actually kill anyone. He did hurt some people, though. Killing people is not, like, how far you have to go. But that's all for a different thing. It's not actually a part of the summary. This is the whole summary, though. They're standing in his parlor still, looking out the window during the morning, having this conversation. And Kemp is still seemingly trying to stall for something to happen. That's a pretty good summary, I think. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you come back for the next one. I'll see y'all later. Bye.